Hello everyone, welcome all of you. Today I am going to share biography and works of John Webster. So let's start the video with the introduction of John Webster. John Webster was born in 1578 or 1588 and died in 1630 or 72. It is quite uncertain still. He was a post-Shakespearean English dramatist, means he emerged as a dramatist after Shakespeare. His personal history is still unknown. Webster is considered as a powerful dramatist after Shakespeare. His contemporaries were Shakespeare, Jonson, Beaumont, Fletcher, Middleton, Dacre, Heywood, and many others. Cyril Turner and John Webster are sometimes taken as a pair of dramatists for containing hopelessness and terrible dramatic element in their plays, which means both have some similar qualities. There we can find hopelessness and terrible dramatic element in their play. T.S. Eliot commented on Webster that Webster always saw the skull beneath the skin, which is a very famous quote by Eliot on Webster. It can be mentioned in your answer. He flourished during the first 20 years of the 17th century under the reign of King James I. King James I became king after the death of Queen Elizabeth, which was still the age of Renaissance. Renaissance was the age of revival of art and literature. It was an age of new learning, reformation, discovery, and new science. And this spirit of Renaissance can be seen in the plays of John Webster. Let's see the historical background of Webster's period. From 1500 to 1660, it is generally known as the Renaissance period or early modern period. From 1558 to 1603 is known as the Elizabethan age, wherein Queen Elizabeth was the Queen of England. From 1603 to 1605, which was the age of Jacobian, and wherein King James was the King of England. From 1625 to 1649, which is the Carolingian age, and from 1649 to 1660, which is known as the Commonwealth period or the Puritan interregnum. Webster works. Webster is better known for writing two great revenge tragedies, The White Devil and The Duchess of Malfi. The White Devil, which appeared in 1610, which is a revenge tragedy, and it was first performed in the Red Bull Theatre openly. While The Duchess of Malfi, which appeared in 1614, which is also a revenge tragedy, and it first appeared privately in the Blackfriars Theatre. The third play, which is The Devil's Law Case, which appeared either 1617 or 23. And it is a tragic comedy. Let's know what is revenge tragedy. Revenge tragedy or play or tragedy of blood, all are same. It is a kind of or a type of tragedy wherein someone, usually a hero or villain, rights a wrong or takes revenge against someone. Like Shakespeare's Hamlet. We all know Hamlet is one of the four major great tragedies of Shakespeare, and it is a revenge tragedy wherein Hamlet is the protagonist of the play. And when Hamlet come to know that his father was actually murdered by his own uncle, and after knowing it, he affirmed himself to take revenge. So Webster's play The White Devil, The Duchess of Malfi, both are revenge plays. The earliest example of revenge play is Aeschylus' Oresia. Aeschylus was a Greek playwright, and his play Oresia is a revenge tragedy, which is the earliest example of revenge play. Webster's The White Devil. The original title of the play is The White Devil or The Tragedy of Paul Giordano Orsini, Duke of Bracciano, with the life and death of Vittoria Corombona, the famous Venetian courtesan. The white devil stands for the devil disguised as a virtuous man or the hypocrite, which means white stands for good while the devil stands for bad. So somebody is trying to represent himself that he is good, but internally he is very bad, very harmful. So the white devil stands for the devil disguised as a virtuous man. He looks good, but he is very bad inside. Flamino is one of the most important characters in the play, and he plays a central role. In this play, he utters the memorable word, and the word is, "We think kids buzzing when indeed they cry." This memorable word is asked in many exams, so you can write it. Next work is Bev Stearns' The Duchess of Malfi, which is a remarkable revenge play, and the original title of the play is The Treasury of the Duchess of Malfi. The Duchess is the central character of the play, and she is a young widow, and she is prohibited not to marry by her two brothers, the Cardinal and the Ferdinand, but she marries Antonio, her own household steward. And this secret marriage of Antonio and the Duchess becomes the cause of her death. She is assassinated by her own brothers with the help of Boussola. Boussola is also a major character in this play. He is hired by Ferdinand, and he is a spy who keeps an eye on the Duchess. So it was a short introduction regarding Webster biography and his works. I hope it will be helpful, and if you have any query regarding Webster, you can comment me, and for PDF note you can send a mail on roshansrest@gmail.com. So thank you for being here. Thank you very much.